Senator Heinrich.
Mr. Comey, prior to January 27th of this year, have you ever had a one-on-one meeting or a private dinner with a president of the United States?
No. I met dinner, no. I had two one-on-ones with President Obama that I laid out in my testimony, once to talk about law enforcement issues, law enforcement and race, which was an important topic throughout for me and for the president, and then once very briefly for him to say goodbye.
Were those brief interactions?
No. The one about law enforcement and race and policing, we spoke for probably over an hour, just the two of us.
How unusual is it to have a one-on-one dinner with the president? Did that strike you as odd?
Yeah, so much so that I assumed there would be others, that he couldn't possibly be having dinner with me alone.
Do you have an impression that if you had found, if you had behaved differently in that dinner, and I am quite pleased that you did not, but if you had found a way to express some sort of expression of loyalty or given some suggestion that the Flynn criminal investigation might be pursued less vigorously, do you think you would have still been fired?
I don't know. It's impossible to say looking back. I don't know.
But you felt like those two things were directly relevant to your the kind of relationship that the president was seeking to establish with you?
Sure, yes.
Yeah. The president has repeatedly talked about the Russian investigation into the U.S. Or the Russia's involvement in the U.S. election cycle as a hoax and as fake news. Can you talk a little bit about what you saw as FBI director, and obviously only the parts that you can share in this setting, that demonstrate how serious this action actually was and why there was an investigation in the first place?
Yes, sir. There should be no fuzz on this whatsoever. The Russians interfered in our election during the 2016 cycle. They did it with purpose. They did it with sophistication. They did it with overwhelming technical efforts. And it was an active measures campaign driven from the top of that government. There is no fuzz on that. It is a high confidence judgment of the entire intelligence community, and the members of this committee have seen the intelligence. It's not a close call. That happened. That's about as unfake as you can possibly get, and is very, very serious, which is why it's so refreshing to see a bipartisan focus on that, because this is about America, not about any particular party.
So that was a hostile act by the Russian government against this country?
Yes, sir.
Did the president, in any of those interactions that you've shared with us today, ask you what you should be doing or what our government should be doing or the intelligence community to protect America against Russian interference in our election system?
I don't recall a conversation like that.
Never?
No.
Do you find odd?
Not with President Trump.
Right.
I attended a fair number of meetings on that with President Obama.
Do you find it odd that the president seemed unconcerned by Russia's actions in our election?
I can't answer that because I don't know what other conversations he had with other advisors or other intelligence community leaders. So I just don't know sitting here.
Did you have any interactions with the president that suggested he was taking that hostile action seriously?
I don't remember any interactions with the president other than the initial briefing on January the 6th. I don't remember, could be wrong, but I don't remember any conversations with him at all about that.
As you're very aware, it was only the two of you in the room for that dinner. You've told us that the president asked you to back off the Flynn investigation. The president told a reporter.
Not in that dinner.
Fair enough. Told the reporter he never did that. You've testified that the president asked for your loyalty in that dinner. The White House denies that. A lot of this comes down to who should we believe. Do you want to say anything as to why we should believe you?
Probably, my mother raised me not to say things like this about myself, so I'm not going to. I think people should look at the whole body of my testimony,
mm-hmm.
because as I used to say to juries, that when I talked about a witness, you can't cherry pick it. You can't say, I like these things he said, but on this, he's a dirty, rotten liar.
Right.
You got to take it all together, and I've tried to be open and fair and transparent and accurate. A really significant fact to me is, so why did he kick everybody out of the Oval Office? Why would you kick the Attorney General, the President, the Chief of Staff out to talk to me if it was about something else? And so that to me, as an investigator, is a very significant fact.
And as we look at testimony or as communication from both of you, we should probably be looking for consistency.
Well, in looking at any witness, you look at consistency, track record, demeanor, record over time, that sort of thing.
Thank you. So there are reports that the incoming Trump administration, either during the transition and or after the inauguration, attempted to set up a sort of backdoor communication channel with the Russian government using their infrastructure, their devices or facilities. What would be the risks, particularly for a transition, someone not actually in the office of the president yet, to setting up unauthorized channels with a hostile foreign government, especially if they were to evade our own American intelligence services?
I'm not going to comment on whether that happened in an open setting, but the risk is, primary risk is obvious. You spare the Russians the cost and effort of having to break into our communications channels by using theirs. And so you make it a whole lot easier for them to capture all of your conversations and then to use those to the benefit of Russia against the United States.
The memos that did you write all nine of them in a way that was designed to prevent them from needing classification?
No. And on a few of the occasions I sent emails to my chief of staff or others on some of the brief phone conversations that I recall. The first one was a classified briefing. Although it wasn't in a SCIF, it was in a conference room at Trump Tower, mm-hmm. it was a classified briefing, and so I wrote that on a classified device. The one I started typing
gotcha.
In the car, that was a classified laptop that I started working on.
Any reason in a classified environment, in a SCIF, that this committee it would not be appropriate to see those communications from, at least from your perspective as the author?
No.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman.